deep in a dark underground vault, a loud trademarked whirring sound echoes off the thick concrete walls. A bright blue TARDIS apparates into view. William Hartnell, Patrick Troughton, John Pertwee, Tom Baker, Peter Davidson, Colin Baker, Sylvester McCoy, Paul McGann, Christopher Eccleston, David Tennant, Matt Smith, Malcolm Tucker, and the 13th Doctor, Rupert Grint, steps out of the TARDIS like a clown car. Some of them look like clowns more than others. I'm looking at you, Tom Baker. What happened? Asked David Tennant. It looks like our timelines have converged, said Paul McGann, but no one was listening. The universe must have brought us together because something terrible is happening. Does anyone have a copy of today's Guardian? Maybe if we read the news, we can work it out. Let's see, says Colin Baker, who was the kind of guy who kept old newspapers around. Ah, here we go, The Guardian, on
April 9th, 2015.
He began to read the headlines. Prince Harry is visiting Australia. Greek political unrest and deepening debt crisis fuel talk of snap election. Christ, the newspaper is boring today. There must be a reason we're all brought together, says a soft voice from behind them. The 13 men spin around. A lady with a kind face and greying hair smiles at them. Who the hell are you? Growls Malcolm Tucker. Oh, my name is Gretchen. I was the doctor in the early 90s, but they didn't film any of my adventures, which was a shame. They were brilliant. There was that one where I swept the TARDIS and the one where I emptied the dishwasher. Those were the days. But the male doctors had stopped listening and had begun comparing penis sizes, which is what they did whenever they got together. It was such a rare phenomenon for multiple doctors to be brought together in one place that they got distracted by the opportunity to do things they had never got the chance to do before. So instead of saving the world, they played that guessing game where they stuck pieces of paper on their foreheads with a personality on each one and took turns at guessing things like, have I met this person before? Not yet. They also played a round of hide and seek in the TARDIS, which took 20 days to complete. I know something we would all really like, said Tom Baker, unravelling his scarf. Heroin! Exclaimed the doctors in unison as Tom Baker wrapped the scarf tightly around Matt Smith's upper arm. What about opium? Suggested Sherlock Holmes, who was only there because Stephen Moffat. The doctors only ever took heroin when they were together, so they could take turns looking after one another. That's the responsible way to take heroin. This is great, thought Paul McGann. And he had a sudden moment of déjà vu, which was surprisingly seldom for someone who happened to travel a lot through time and space. Black holes. Black holes. The Large Hadron Collider. You see, there are 100 million black holes in the universe, each of them created when a planet has invented their own version of the Large Hadron Collider. 100 million times the doctor's timelines have converged to save the galaxy, and 100 million times they have been so distracted from heroin they failed to notice the Large Hadron Collider creating black holes and destroying galaxies. In fact, if they hadn't been so distracted, they would have read The Guardian on this day,
April 9th,
that the Large Hadron Collider has been switched back on. So as the Hadron Collider has been fired up, ready to suck us all into a black hole in the coming weeks, the doctors have made their escape. They didn't have time to save our solar system, but they did have time to do more heroin. So every time you look into space and see a black hole, make a wish and leave a lemon by your fireplace for a doctor who might drop by, because lemons are the cheapest and therefore most popular way to dissolve heroin. And that, my friends, is the theory of everything.
Oh, what tends to happen is someone heckles you something that you did not know anyone would ever say to you, and then you spend at least that night, the next couple of days, responding to it. You find the perfect...